Welcome back, friends. In this video, we are going to see a code walkthrough of JWT implementation. Okay. In the last two videos, I have explained the first one is just a demo of JWT, then concept of JWT. The second one is basic authentication. Please watch these two videos to better understanding of this particular video. Okay. If you want to understand this video, you have to watch the last two video, otherwise definitely you cannot understand. Here I'm going to explain only JWT part. As part of basic authentication, I have explained how to implement a security framework in Spring Boot application. Okay, I will not cover much on that. Only I'm going to focus on JWT related coding part. In order to implement security in a Spring Boot application, we need this web security config adapter. This I have already explained in basic authentication. However, I'll going to tell what I did part of our billing system. For part of billing system, I have done something, right? That part I'll going to tell here. Okay. So this authentication service. This authentication service is a my own class, which is coming from user detail service. This user detail service, I have overwrite one method called load user by username. In the basic authentication, I have hard coded the username and password. I have hard coded the username and password, but here I am taking the username dynamically from the database. In that override method implementation, when you look at here, I am using user repository dot find by email ID. User repository is my repository class. This will read the data from user table. Here I have defined one method called find by email ID. This will return a user information matches with this email ID. Okay. In authentication service. In authentication service, I am using that repository class. I am fetching the user information. Forgot about this coding part. This is related to roles. I will go to explain about the role in next video. Here, I am taking the user information from the database. Then, I am initializing user detail object. This user detail object is a Spring-based user detail object. I am initializing this user details. Then passing username and the password from my user object, which is coming from database. Third parameter is authority. We need to pass authority. In this code, just I am initializing two classes, grant authority role. This grant authority role is a Spring class. It's a Spring security class. Using this class, I am initializing two roles. One is super admin, another one is role employee. One is super admin, another one is role employee. Then I am initializing one array list. That array list should contain grant authority role object. Grant authority role object. Then I am adding these two objects in my list. These two objects in my list. That meaning now this user detail contains two roles called super admin role user. Whatever users coming from database, I am assigning two roles to that user here. Okay, actually this is kind of hard coding, but I should not do this. This is not a perfect implementation of roles. I have to work on that role still. What I am doing here, I am fetching the user, then initializing the two roles. That role object I am passing here as a third parameter. That's it. But the final implementation of role is whenever take the user object, that user object should contain automatically that roles. That is our end expectation, final expectation. But here what I am doing is, here I am manually initializing the role, creating a role, then assigning that role to the user object. Okay. JWT request filter is another class I auto-wired in this security configurator. This is for validating users, validating credentials. Okay, whenever user call particular endpoint, I want to validate the particular endpoint request coming from authorized person. That validation I am doing instead of JWT request filter. Okay, we will going to see about this later. Okay, Then here I have override and I have, sorry, here I have override three methods. One is configure, another one is configure, another one is authentication manager bit. This configure method having one parameter called authentication manager builder. In this authentication manager builder class, I am calling one method called user detail service. That user detail service accepting one parameter called authentication service. Authentication service nothing but it's accepting parameter user detail service. It accepting user detail service. Okay. Purpose of this configuration is whenever user enter username and the password, I want to validate that username and the password valid or not. For that, we need to load the username and the password from the database, right? For that purpose, I am using authentication service class. From the authentication service, through authentication service, I am loading username and the password. Then I am validating that username and the password against the username and the password that entered by the client. Okay, now this is the configuration I am saying here. Use of this configuration is, through this configuration, I am providing some access restriction. I am providing some access restriction for particular endpoints. Okay. Authorize request.antmatcher. Here I am passing two endpoints. One is api public/authenticate, api public/refresh token. These two endpoints anyone can access. That's the reason I am giving a permit all. Permit all meaning is whatever endpoint you are passing inside this, this endpoint can access everybody. It's a public access. Okay. Then second one, dot antmatcher. I am passing api /private/user/?? Okay. This particular path can access only who is having a role, employee role, who is having a role, super admin. These two kind of people can access this particular path. Other people cannot be accessed. Okay. That is the definition of this line. Then I am saying .anyrequest.authenticator. Meaning of this line is, if user having a role, employee role or super admin role, they can access this URL, but they have to be authorized. They have to be authorized. That is, they have to give proper username and password. System should validate that username and password. If the username and password valid, then only you have to authenticate that person to go inside the application. Otherwise, don't allow him. That is the meaning of this particular line. Okay, even they have role, employee role, super admin, they have to properly logged in. Okay, properly authorized. That is the meaning of this line. Then I am saying that session policy. I am saying that session creation policy as a stateless. Then finally, I am calling one filter, JWT filter. This filter I want to call before firing username password authentication filter. Before firing username password authentication filter. This filter will call and execute whatever code I have implemented inside a JWT request filter. I will going to explain that soon. Then I am overriding third method called authentication manager. Through this method, I am initializing authentication manager. This authentication manager I am using in user public controller. This class for authenticate username password that entered by the client. I will go to explain later. Okay, this is the purpose of this particular override method. The final one is password encoder. This is not an override method. I am initializing a password encoder bin with a normal password, not a encrypted password. I will going to implement later the encrypted password. Okay, now it's a normal password only. Okay, we have to define this bin, otherwise we cannot test, we cannot implement the Spring security. We have to do this. This is the configuration of a security in a building system. Now we're going to see user public controller. Okay, in user public controller I have implemented two endpoints. In user public controller, I have implemented two endpoints. One is authenticate, another one is a refresh token. This both endpoint is a public accessible. Okay, it's visible to everybody. Anyone can access. If they have proper username and password, they can generate the access token and refresh token to access subsequent request. Okay. Now we will go into walk through this authenticate method. Okay. This authentication manager class, I have already told that this is for authenticate username and password. Here, authentication manager dot authenticate, I am passing username and password in the form of username password authentication token. Inside the username password authentication token, I am passing username and password. This object I am passing inside authenticate. When you do like this, what will happen? This authenticate method internally called load user by name, which is defined in authentication service. It will call this method and pass this username. Then it will return user details from the database. Now that user detail is having username and password. That username and password validate against this username and password. Okay. If that username and password is valid, this code executes successfully and come to here. This code get executed successfully, come to here. If the authentication is not valid, it will come to catch block, throw the exception saying invalid username password exception. Okay. If this code executed perfectly, this code executed successfully, that meaning our username and password authenticated properly, then I want to generate JWT. I want to generate JWT token. Okay. For that, line number 53, again I am calling the load by username. I am calling load by username. I am taking the user details. Now this user detail, I am passing inside a generate auth response method, which is coming from authentication service class. I am passing user detail inside a generate auth response. In the second parameter, I am passing access token. Access token, that is which type of token you want to generate, that type I am passing. Here I want to generate access token, so I am passing token type equal to access token. Then first parameter I am passing user detail. When you look at this method, in this method the first line I am calling find by username. Find by username of, I am calling user details dot username, that is whatever username entered by the user, entered by the client. Okay, that username I am passing here. For that username, any JWT token already exists, that JWT token information assigned to this JWT token object. I have a table called JWT token. In that table, I am maintaining all JWT information like access token, refresh token, expiration of access token, expiration of refresh token. Those information I maintain the JWT token. If that JWT token already available for this user, I am fetching that record assigning to in this object. See here, this is the table JWT token, username and access token information, then refresh token information, then expiration of access token, expiration of refresh token. Okay, everything available in this particular table. If this record is exist, the JWT token object get populated. Okay, then if a token generation type is success token, come to here. In the case of authentication point, generation type is success token only. Okay, so it will come to here. In the first line, the 68th line, I'm calling one method called generate access token. This method coming from JWT utils. JWT util is a class. It is a utility class for manipulating JWT token. It's a utility class for manipulating and generating JWT token. Okay, inside this class I'm calling a generate access token. This is a generate access token with a parameter of user detail. In this method, in the first line I'm initializing a empty mesh map, then again I'm calling create token. This is the create token implementation. In this create token I'm generating actually, in this create token, I'm generating actual JWT token here. Okay. In this generate access token, I'm initializing map, empty map. That map I'm passing first parameter. This is the first parameter. Then I'm passing username. Username is a called as a subject here. Okay. Then what type of token you want to generate, whether access token or refresh token. I'm passing access token here. Okay. Since I'm passing access token, come to here. Here I'm saying return JWTs.builder.setClients. JWT is API from JWT, it's an inbuilt API. Using that API, I am building the client. Client nothing but, when I explain about the JWT token, there is a second portion. The second portion is a payload portion, right? That payload portion is called as a client. Okay, that client we have to populate here. Set clients dot set subject, nothing but set subject, nothing but a username. Subject nothing but a currently logged in username. Then set issued at. Issued at nothing but I am issued at nothing but when that particular token generated. Here I am setting current date and time for issued at. Third one, I am setting expiration when the token want to expire. For that, I am setting current time plus access token expiration. What is this variable? This variable coming from here. This variable value coming from this particular property. This property I defined in YAML file, application YAML file. This is the property I am defining here. I am saying here 50 lakhs. 50 lakhs nothing but it's a 1 plus day. More than 1 day. Okay. More than 1 day. That is current time plus more than 1 day. I am setting expiration day. I am setting expiration day is a 1 plus day here. Okay. Finally, sign in with method, I am generating the token. I am generating a token. Then the authorization service. Then authorization service, the generate token I am calling, that doing those process, whatever I explained, those process is doing. Finally, it's written a one access token. Then again, I'm calling JWTutils.extractClaims. These extractClaims, whatever claim I set while generating access token, those claims that return and assign to here. I will tell why I'm keeping here later. Okay. Like that, I'm generating refresh token also. A refresh token is very similar to generate access token. Whatever process I am doing inside a generate access token, same thing I am doing inside a generate refresh token. Only one difference is access token lifetime is very less when compared to refresh token. Then I am calling JWT installed extract claims. After generating refresh token, from this token, I am taking whatever claim I set while generating refresh token. That claims I am assigning here. These two variables I will going to use later point of in this code. Okay. After doing this particular calls, then initializing authentication response DTO. This authentication response DTO is a client response object. After successful generation of access token, refresh token, all information I am showing to the client in this authentication response structure. Okay, when you look at the authentication response structure, access token, refresh token, then access token expiration date, refresh token expiration date. Okay, this information I'll going to show to the client after successful generating access token and the refresh token. Okay, I'm setting access token, refresh token, then username. Then here I'm setting the token expiration date, token access token expiration date and a refresh token expiration date. This expiration date available inside the claims. Okay, from this claim, I'm taking and setting into the my response object. That is the purpose of I'm taking the claims here. Okay. Now next step is we're going to walk through how I am generating refresh token. Okay. Now we're going to see what is the purpose of this refresh token endpoint. Okay. Using this authenticate, what we have done, using this authenticate endpoint, where we can generate access token and a refresh token. Using access token, client can send a request, they can get a response. They can, the access token is an authorization token. By providing the token, client can invoke any web services. Okay, that is the purpose of access token. What is the purpose of refresh token? Access token expire anytime, right? After expiration of access token, we need to generate again new access token. For that purpose, we have a refresh token. For that purpose, we are using a refresh token. Client send a refresh token to the server. Server validate that refresh token. If the refresh token is valid, then server generate a new access token. Then that access token given to client for further subsequent web services call. For further subsequent web service call. Okay, that is the purpose of refresh token. This endpoint for generating a new access token by providing new refresh token, by providing a refresh token. Okay, when you look at this method, there is a request body, authentication request info. In this authentication request info, we have an attribute called refresh token. Client should send the refresh token in this form. Okay, in this form. In this server side, I am taking the refresh token, assigned with the refresh token variable. Here I am verifying this refresh token is expired or not. If expired, I am throwing the error saying that refresh token is expired. Okay, otherwise, what I am doing here? I am calling load user by username method from authentication service. In the first parameter, I am passing username. How I am passing username? This refresh token contains logged in username in the form of subject. Okay, I want to take that subject. For that, I am using one utility method called extract username. Extract username coming from JWT utils class. Using the extract username, I can extract the username available inside a refresh token. Okay, I am doing here that only. This method return a username. Using that username, I am loading the user detail from the database. Okay, now this user detail contains username and the password, everything. Okay, using this user detail, I am authenticating. If that username and the password is valid, this code execute perfectly. Otherwise, this will return this exception. Now username and the password is valid, this particular code execute. Otherwise, this will return invalid username password exception. Let's assume that given username password is valid, it will come here. Then I am calling authentication service dot generate auth response. Then generate auth response. Whatever method I am calling here, the same method I am calling here also. When you look at this method, in this method I am passing a refresh token as the second parameter. That meaning I want to generate refresh token. I am telling to this method, hey, I want to generate refresh token this time by passing user details. So it will come to refresh token block. This come to refresh token block. Whatever I am doing here, the same thing I am doing here, except this particular lines. I am not generating refresh token. Here I am generating only access token. Only access token. After generating access token, I am setting the necessary information, response information inside the authentication response DTO. Setting access token, then setting the refresh token. Refresh token which is already I am using, that refresh token I am setting here. Okay, I am not generating any new refresh token. Then I am setting username. Then I am setting that token expiration date of access token and refresh token. Then ID, the token ID, that's it. This information I am setting inside this block, that's it. Okay, when you look at this method, when you look at this block, I am not generating refresh token. Refresh token I am taking from JWT token object. Where is this JWT token coming from? This JWT token I am populating from find by username, which is coming from JWT token repository. That is, I am fetching JWT token detail from JWT token table by passing username. By passing username, I am taking JWT token object. This JWT token object contains access token, refresh token, everything. Okay, in this block I am generating new access token. That new access token setting it to in the access token method, but JWT token, the refresh token I am taking from JWT token object, which is coming from database. That meaning it's an existing refresh token. I am not generating a new one. In the case of generating a new access token using refresh token. Okay. Once I am setting all the information in authentication response ETO, it is returning back to user public controller. In this user public controller, I am passing this response object inside a save JWT method, which is coming from authentication service. When look at this save JWT, I am converting this authentication response to JWT token object. Then this JWT token object I am passing to save method. That meaning I am updating new access token in my database. Okay. After doing this, I am sending this authentication response ETO as a response object in a client side. Okay. Yeah, that's it, guys. This is about refresh token and authenticate endpoint. If you're not able to understand, please comment me or please call me. Definitely, I'll going to explain whichever part you are not able to understand. Okay, from the next video onwards, I'm going to post only the functionality part, billing system functionality part. So far, most of the videos which I posted only for Spring Boot related technical topics. Okay, from now on, I'm going to post only billing system functionality part. Okay, please share this video to your friend circle and then colleagues. Whoever wanted to gain real-time project experience, please share this channel. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.